Hi, you're watching VSDC channel. In this video, we're going to talk about the adjustment video effects available in the free version of VSDC Video Editor. Adjustments are the biggest group of effects in VSDC, and unlike special effects or transitions, they help you achieve an overall better look of the video. Let's see how each effect in this group works. The first three effects are named Auto Levels, Auto Contrast, and Auto Gamma. Let's start with Auto Levels. This effect quickly applies automatic enhancements to the video by making the colors pop. If you apply this effect, you'll probably notice that the video becomes more vibrant. Technically, this happens because Auto Levels bring color tone values to their maximum, so that the image uses the entire color and brightness spectrum. Auto Contrast improves the contrast settings of the video. Here's how it works. The program analyzes all three color channels, then makes dark tone pixels black, lightens bright tone pixels to the point when they become white, and rebalances tones in between. Similarly, Auto Gamma reassigns color tone values in a way that makes them form a broader range of brightness values. The original brightest tone value is assigned to white color. The darkest tone value is assigned to black color. The rest of the values are evenly distributed across the grayscale. Finally, the brightness contrast gamma corrects color brightness, contrast, and gamma values in your video. There are three controls you can toggle, from 100 to negative 100 to increase or decrease the values. Zero means the default settings. As you move the control, you can see the value, or you can also manually type any number here. Let's have a quick look at each parameter. When you change brightness, you make all colors in the video darker or brighter. This parameter shifts all pixel values up or down in the range of tones. Contrast helps you increase the difference between bright and dark pixels in the video. As you increase the intensity, you make bright zones in the video even brighter without brightening the dark zones. Gamma allows you to make details more distinct. If you are dealing with a low contrast video or image, without changing the balance of lights and shadows. Moving on to the next group of settings. Red, green, and blue, also known as RGB curves, allow you to correct colors in your video quickly and precisely. You can adjust values manually or using curves. RGB curves are used to adjust brightness and color tone ranges in the video. The main curve is a straight white line that controls brightness values. When you make changes to the brightness curve, it affects all three color channels. To add highlights, drag the control point to the top right area. To add shadows, drag the control point to the lower left area. To adjust different tone areas, add control points directly to the curve. To lighten or darken the tone area, drag the control point up or down. To increase or decrease the contrast, drag the control point to the left or right. Now let's see what the Hue Saturation Value and Hue Saturation Lightness options mean. Hue means color tone. It can be red, green, or blue. Hue values can range from 0 to 360. Saturation values can range from 0 to 100. And the way this parameter works is that the higher its value, the clearer, more vibrant the colors are. When saturation value is close to zero, the colors will look more neutral and grayish. Finally, lightness is the level of tone brightness, and it also varies from 0 to 100. Luminance Chrominance is a model where each color contains three components. Y is a brightness component. If you only leave this one, the video will consist of gray color tones only. U is the blue color component. And V is the red color component. This color model will be useful if you are working with VHS and analog videos. LUTs, also known as lookup tables. This option allows you to apply pre-designed LUTs to your video or create your own LUTs and perform in-depth color correction like a pro. Since we have a dedicated video about LUTs, we suggest watching it if you want to learn more about the topic. Color Twist is a more newbie-friendly color correction tool that allows you to work directly with RGB channels. We suggest watching this tutorial if you want to learn more. Grayscale converts a color image to black and white, including only black, white, and gray tones. Equalize and Equalize Histogram change pixel values to achieve a more even distribution of brightness or color in the video. The RGB control balances out the image based on the red, green, and blue channels. Brightness improves balance based on the brightness of each pixel. Colorize enhances the areas that lack color in your video or image. This is the effect you want to use to make a monochrome video colorful. And Sepia, the effect everyone probably knows about. This effect can easily make your video or image look antique by applying warm brown tones to it. The next group of effects is designed to help you stylize your video and correct visual flaws. Let's start with the option named Reducing Bit Resolution. This effect makes your video or image look like a poster or a newspaper photo by decreasing the number of colors and applying the dot design, also used for poster production. Dither type defines the painting style used for the effect. Noise sets the depth of visual noise in the video. Levels defines the number of colors in each color channel. You can put anything between 1 and 255. Posterize is an effect that reduces the number of colors in each color channel. When using this effect, you can set any value from 1 to 255. It means the number of colors in each color channel. However, a human eye doesn't really notice changes above 35. So we suggest that you use any value from 1 to 35 to really see the difference. Solarize effect is also known as Solar Curve, Ed's Curve, and Ed Manning's Solar Curve. This is a curve that helps you notice visual flaws of the image, or video in our case. There are two modes you can use, and the main difference between them is the solar curve frequency or sensitivity. For example, the first method will help you see visual flaws in bright and dark zones without distorting the video too much. However, if you want to find minor flaws that are less noticeable, the second method will work much better. Levels allow you to change the values at the beginning of the curve. Porabolize has a similar purpose to the Solarize effect. They both distort the video to the point when you can see all the visual flaws that may stand out, such as spots, stains, hairs. The difference between these two effects is the curve frequency and the two different modes the Solarize effect has for bright and dark zones. The temperature effect can help you correct color temperature in the video. If the temperature is too high, consider decreasing it to any value between 0 and 255. If the temperature is too low, consider increasing it to any value between 0 and 255. Tint helps you control the saturation of red and green color tones in the video. Inverse makes all color tones in the video inverse to their opposites, but you can also control the intensity of the effect. Negative just reverses all control tones in the video to their opposites. The black and white effect sets a benchmark so that all pixels above this value are converted to white. and all pixels below are converted to black. This option provides three black and white processing modes based on the average, lightness, and luminance values. Threshold sets a benchmark for each color channel so that all pixels above this value are converted to white, and all pixels below this value are converted to black. Plus, it brings a photo mode that is similar to Posterize.